Hello, and welcome to Customer Effects Training Snippets. Today we're going to be talking about creating a new lead in SalesLogix web client. My name is Dale Richter, and I'll be your trainer for the day. Let me switch over here to my web client. And now we're viewing the web client and looking at the leads area. As you see on the left-hand side of the screen, I have leads clicked on. I do have some current leads in there, and we have a couple things we can do. We can import leads here, or we can add an individual lead one at a time. And that's what we're going to be doing in this training snippet, is just adding an individual lead. In another snippet, we'll look at actually using the import wizard to import many at one time. So if I go up to my new menu up on the top here and just click on new, and then I'm going to choose new lead here. And it brings up my dialog box to insert a lead. So I'm just going to put in my contact name here. And the company. And a website. And then I can go ahead and click on look for matching records. When I click for look for matching records here, it's going to search and look for any potential matches that may be in there. So when the match filters come up here, I can choose whether I want to look in contact, lead, or account. I'm going to choose to look in all three of them. I'm going to look for the first name, the last name, the web address, and the company name. And then I'm going to click on Update Potential Matches again, where it's going to go search again here and look at all those that I had checked there. If any matches came up, they'd come up at the bottom of the screen here. You'll see we're not coming up with any matches at this point. So I'm just going to cancel this screen, which brings me back to my main insert lead screen. So over on the right here, then I can continue on and put in my email address, phone number, you'll notice for the phone number that I just put in a straight 10 digits. When I tabbed out of the field, it automatically formatted it for me. There's a title field here I can choose from the pick list. I'm just going to click on the pick list there. Choose one of the existing titles. You can also freehand type in that field. And then for the address fields, I'm going to click on the little pencil over on the right here to edit that. When I edit that, now you see all the individual fields. So I can put in address line 1. And then I'm going to tab down and put in the city. State field, postal code, I'm not using county or country here. I only deal within the United States, so I'm not going to worry about country unless it's outside of the United States. I'm just going to click on OK there. I can choose an industry here. I can also put in a SIC code. If you use SIC codes, that's just a code that tells you what industry they're in. There is a place over on the right here for a business description and what they may be interested in, if we know that at this point. And down at the bottom here, we also have a comments field. If you'd like to put in any comments in where you received this lead, I can just type in here, talk to Tom at the yearly trade show. I'm going to go ahead in the upper right-hand corner, make sure that I save my lead. Now at that point, it's inserted my lead into my database. Now remember, leads actually sit in a totally separate table from our contacts. So when we look up a lead, we are not searching the contact table. When we search a contact, we're not looking at the lead table. So they do sit totally separate. Once I've created that lead, I over on the right here, I have some lead qualification questions that I can answer. And those qualification questions, there's several different sets of questions that we can choose from here. And we can also set up our own qualification questions as a company if we wish to. As we scroll down a little bit farther on the record, we see we do have some do not solicit checkboxes if they choose not to be emailed or not mailed. And then down at the bottom of the screen, we have all of our different tabs showing the details that we could put in a last call date or our next call date. But now we can actually schedule activities here under Activities tab, so we can schedule phone calls, meetings, to-dos with this lead. And as they're completed, they will end up in the History tab. There's an Attachments tab there also where we can attach records. Our Marketing tab for any campaigns that we send out to this individual. And then our Responses tab showing any responses from this individual to any of the campaigns that we have put out there. So once we have this lead in, remember we're basically working on this lead for a short period of time until we answer all the qualification questions. And at that point is when we would convert them into a qualified lead. In another snippet, I will talk about converting a qualified lead. This one we just wanted to look at how to insert a new lead, which again we did through the new menu, just went to new lead, and this is inserting one lead at a time. Remember, we can also import leads, and we'll talk about that also in another snippet, how to import leads using the import leads wizard. Let me jump back here. So in this webinar, we just looked at how to create a new lead in the web client. In future webinars, we'll look at how to convert that lead into a contact and also how to create qualification questions. I want to thank you all for joining me this afternoon and have a great day.